almost like ayahuasca is here to help us really shift our consciousness.
Hi, my name's Rebekah Shaman. I came here to Machu Picchu in 1997 to work as a culture and activities manager in a hotel in Machu Picchu. It was one of the bigger hotels in Aguas Calientes, the village of Machu Picchu. And I was really looking forward to doing some local work, to helping the community and seeing how the hotel could more work with the local community. But during my time there, I saw the opposite. I saw environmental damage. I saw the local community not being included in big decisions that were being made. I saw local entrepreneurship being crushed by big businesses. And I saw that the big tourist industries here weren't supporting the local communities, but utilizing their resources. One day, when I was feeling really lost, I went for a run on that mountain straight ahead. It had been a difficult day and I wasn't really thinking about what I was doing, and I found myself climbing right to almost at the top of that mountain and reaching a point where the path was not there anymore. So I climbed around it and I realised that I was in trouble and that the only way down was down that rock face. In that moment I called out for some help. Anything, save me, understand why I was here in Peru, what had it all been about. I saw my dream had completely crumbled, but I didn't know what else to do, or I didn't want to go back to England, and I couldn't understand what was happening. And then I fell down that rock face and I was saved by a tree that was jutting out, and from there I was able to get down from the mountain. That evening I walked out onto the balcony of the office and I just called out to the mountains, why am I here? Why am I in Peru? I know it's no longer to be at the hotel, but what's my purpose for being here? And in that moment, a shaman came to me in a vision. And he said to me he was waiting for me, and that if I believed in him enough, I would find him. And that I had to come and look for him, and I would find him if I believed in him. The next day, I was given a book called One River about ayahuasca, and I knew that I had to go and find the shaman in Iquitos, in the northern part of the Amazon basin, up in the north part of Peru. And there, I knew if I flew out there and I believed enough in him, I would find him, and that he and the ayahuasca would hold the answers for why I had come to Peru, and for why I was here on this planet, and what was the purpose of me being here. So this is the casita behind me where I lived for 3 months, 3.5 months during my apprenticeship with Don Juanito and Pashquita. I arrived at 7 o'clock in the evening from the colectivo. The stars were out, and as I scrambled up the muddy banks, I was in awe of the casita that stood behind me on stilts made fully from Amazonian materials.
And my heart skipped a beat because I realised how blessed I was to be having my apprenticeship with a family, not just with a shaman. When I clambered up the stairs for the first time and saw Don Juanito, I knew that I had arrived in the right place and that this is where I was going to stay for my apprenticeship. It was an amazing part of the river. It's away from the village, maybe about a kilometre away. As you can see, this is where we do everything. This part of the river is where we bathe, we drink the water, we clean the clothes. It's the source of life here. And behind us is pristine jungle where we hunted and lived from the Amazonian supply abundance that is all around us. It was an amazing experience coming here because everything is in tune with nature. Everything's in flow with nature. We work symbiotically with nature. And to be in such a harmonious environment was an amazing experience for someone who was born and brought up in London. It's such a different world. And yet, I feel so comfortable here. I felt so comfortable here, like this was my home. The family were really welcoming and looked after me as if I was their own daughter and made me feel so welcome. And it was here in the house that we took ayahuasca. The ayahuasca vines that we grow in the chakras and a bit further down, deep into the Amazon. And so even the ayahuasca that we drink is from this area. I trained with Don Juanito by taking ayahuasca 3 times a week, but it was also living in the jungle that was part of my apprenticeship, working in the chakras, learning how to flow with nature, getting out of my mind and much more into a centered heart space, and just being a lot in solitude. Here there's lots of time to just be and just enjoy life and the natural harmony around. The Amazon's so full of life, it's so vibrant with life. So the apprenticeship was more about being in the Amazon and learning to flow with the natural flows of nature than it was actually learning anything specific. The ayahuasca imparted to me a very important message, was that we need to clean ourselves inside in order to experience a different world externally. And if we really want change, the change has to come from within first. And that's what ayahuasca does. It cleans us out of all the fear, the negativity, the doubt, to enable us to really release that so that we can fully be part of this amazing planet from a much more loving place. When we love ourselves and heal ourselves first, we can then love and heal others. When you take it here in the Amazon, you're not just drinking ayahuasca, you're actually absorbing this natural pulse and vibration of the natural world of nature. And so the power of ayahuasca is heightened much more than it is anywhere else. Until we can come here to the Amazon, we know it, but we don't really feel it. And when we come here, it seeps into our soul, into our bodies, into every part of us. And we take a little bit of that away when we leave, still vibrating with that understanding that everything is one, that the natural world and us, there's no separation. And when we understand that, we understand the power and the magic and the blissful experience that life is. Don Juanito died before I was able to say goodbye to him, and Pashko took his place, and now Pashkita is the female shaman of the area. And she, I completed my ayahuasca training with her, having come back to the Amazon after 13 years. Now we're going into El Centro. El Centro was a space that's deep into the Amazon, so when the water rose, it often rose higher than the houses, the casitas that were in the village. So you would come here into the centre, which is much higher up and therefore dry. And we had three gardens where we cultivated our vegetables and fruit. And it's kind of an adventure always to go there because obviously it's quite inside the jungle, so we'd have to use the canoes to take us to a certain place, and then we would walk the rest of the way. I always really loved coming here. It was away from the village, no one else comes here. It was like our little like holiday home. And when everything's got too hectic on the river, the shaman always suggested us coming here to take ayahuasca, where it was really peaceful and quiet and really in nature. So it's a very special place. When I came, it was like fully cultivated, and if you go there now, it's like full jungle. So it really shows the rejuvenation energy of the Amazon. And if a Pueblo cultivates a chakra and leaves it, very soon it becomes jungle again. So there really is a symbiotic relationship with nature and the local people. And here we were able to fish and hunt food as well. There'd be wild boar here, majas, and various other animals that we'd often come here to hunt for meat and then bring it back to the village. And then I planted this 14 years ago in the medicine gardens, and it was really big, and it went all the way up into the sun, and sometime last year it fell, and so we only have the root left. But what we're going to be doing, there it is, there's the root. So it's really old ayahuasca that I planted and now coming to take out and share with the group here. So it's really, really, it's got loads of intention. And what we're going to do now is we're going to have a ceremony to take it out of the ground with all of us who are drinking it. And we're going to cut it up into pieces, and then we're going to bring it to the lodge, and tomorrow we're going to prepare it for ayahuasca. So it's a really amazing opportunity and powerful to come back 14 years later and actually have the opportunity to take it out and be able to drink it and prepare it and drink it. So I would be really good also if everyone just gave themselves some time while we do the ceremony to just be in intention, be here now in the Amazon, and really just be part of the sacredity of taking the ayahuasca out of the ground. And again, it's a root, it's the root of the plant and not the top of the plant. So it's actually, the plant's going to root us into Mother Earth, and that's how I see it, that it's going to really, rather than take us out, it's going to root us in and into our body, so that we can really then take that energy into the world in a very strong centralized way, rather than out there in the mind. It's going to take us into the heart. I'm going to do a ceremony with a mapacho, which kind of clears the energy, and then if everyone wants to spend some time just clearing the area so that we can cut it up, it would be really good to just get your hands a little bit dirty in the earth. Ayahuasca, ayahuasca, curare nosotros con medicina, medicina. Ayahuasca, ayahuasca. Gracias, ayahuasca, oh, gracias, ayahuasca, por todo, ayahuasca, gracias, ayahuasca. Yeah,
Yeah.
Yeah.
The vine of the mother. Does everyone send their intention to this? The mother, to this ayahuasca, has been growing for 14 years so that we can drink it tonight. And send gratitude and love.
Yeah? Yeah, one more turn.
And this is what we've just cut down, and ayahuasca is called the mother of all medicine, and this is because the shamans say that ayahuasca is the medicine that gave them the knowledge of how to make medicine in the Amazon. And how it works is that we add it to chacruna, and chacruna is a leaf that contains DMT. The problem is that when we drink DMT, we have MAO inhibitors in our digestive system that won't allow the chacruna to digest. So we add this vine, Banisteropsis capi, to the mix, and that blocks the MAO inhibitors, enabling the chacruna to absorb in the body and giving us the wisdom of the medicine. How they found out that this vine and those leaves mixed together in order to create such a powerful medicine is the magic of this universe. And what we've done is that we've harvested some of the ayahuasca leaves to put into the mix. This just brings in a more of a having the vine, but the leaves are also quite a powerful medicine in themselves. And what we also add to the mix is tobacco, the mapacho, which is this. And what we do is that tobacco is very important when we cut down the ayahuasca, when we cut down anything or do anything in ceremony, because it clears the energy, it smudges the energy, and it gets us into a sense of understanding and what we're doing. So it grounds the energy and clears the energy. And by singing certain ikaros, it brings the spirits of gratitude into the whole ceremony, enabling the ritual to have an intention and a sacredity to it, and an honoring of the importance of ayahuasca and this very powerful medicine that actually does shift consciousness. Uma parte de todo nate, jayariremos, tomataste, jatariremos, cae por puente todo nate, vapor si estoy que talla, kawakiremos, cae un ante todo nate. So this is Don Juanito's grave. He died in July 2005, and we know he was born in 1924, so he's 81 years old. He was the shaman for the area, and he cured everyone in the village and in the surrounding villages. And he was really well known as a very good shaman, because no one died in his house, and that's a sign of a really good shaman. And lots of people came to take ayahuasca with him. They took it for many reasons, for illnesses, but also if they were feeling confused in their minds. And when I arrived and found Don Juanito, it was really finding an ayahuasquero that could help me on my own journey of healing. I'd been on a long search for healing myself. And when I found Don Juanito and ayahuasca, I knew that that was going to be the final part of my journey, and that it was going to be the ayahuasca that was going to really help me to really understand my own conscious illnesses, my own habits and conditionings that I was desperate to break through ancestrally, and also from my parents and from society. And when I arrived, I knew a little bit about ayahuasca, but I didn't really understand the power of ayahuasca. And it was really Don Juanito who was able to impart so much of his knowledge to me and so much of his own wisdom and understanding of the plant. And he was always really clear about ayahuasca and the importance of taking ayahuasca, and also the importance of what it means to be a shaman. The most important thing I feel he gave me was the understanding that the shaman has to heal themselves first before they can heal others. And ayahuasca is a very internal journey. The ayahuasca heals the person on all levels, not just physically, but mentally, emotionally, and more importantly, consciously. And he used to call me Linda Wawita, which means little baby, and that's how he saw me, and he was right. I was really an emotional wreck when I arrived. And the ayahuasca and Don Juanito both together, with the help of Pashko and the family, really helped heal those parts of me that were fractured and had been shattered. It was a very powerful apprenticeship with him, because he was also looking for someone that he could pass his knowledge on to, and I felt very honoured that he gave me so much of his time, all of his time, to really help me understand what it means to become a healer, what it means to help heal myself in order to help others, and also to open my heart to understanding myself more than anything else, and understanding what it means to be me. And when we know who we are, we can stand in our power. That's true and real empowerment. We have to crack all of the shell that we have around us, the walls that we build up, the fear of being who we truly are. And ayahuasca really helps to break open the shell of illusion, and so that we can really find who we truly are inside ourselves. It was an apprenticeship that contained so much within it. It wasn't about banging a drum or doing ritual or doing something. It was about being. It was about understanding what it meant to be rather than to do. And I'm really grateful to Don Juanito for really standing in his power in order to show me my power. That it wasn't anything external that I needed to do. It was an internal journey. And actually, it wasn't anything around ritual or the Western idea of what it means to be a shaman. It was about taking ayahuasca and really releasing all the fear, the anger, the pain, the conditionings of our consciousness in order to break through and actually really shine our light. And now more than ever on the planet, ayahuasca is needed in order to enable us to break through all this conditioning in order to really connect with ourselves. Throughout my life, it's always been a process of healing and serving, and that's the power that Don Juanito gave me, was the opportunity to heal myself in order to then I could then go out and help to heal others.
Listo para la noche.
Listo para la noche. Okay, so some words of advice on when you take the ayahuasca is to surrender. That is the word. It's just surrender to whatever's happening. Because the more you get into a panic, the more it doesn't serve what's coming up. And the ayahuasca doesn't give you anything that you don't need. So you'll get exactly what you've asked for, basically. And sometimes that can bring up a lot of fear, but at the same time, if you walk through it, you clear it.
So this is a really amazing opportunity to just really clear through some of the big blocks that are holding you back on a conscious level. I really want you to enjoy it. I mean, that's the key, is to really enjoy this ceremony. And the best way of enjoying it is just to allow the ayahuasca to do her work in whatever way that is. So it's not about judging it or wanting anything different. It's really about allowing the ayahuasca to give you what you need. It's now 14 years since I left the Amazon, or since I arrived in the Amazon, since my apprenticeship began, was 14 years ago. And it's been a long journey of integrating what I had learned and understanding the power of what I had been through, and being able to see the shift in consciousness that I've been going through that has really enabled me to be here now and stand by his grave and really feel connected to him even now, even while he's dead. And we have a special wood in the Amazon that doesn't disintegrate in the rain. And I wasn't here when he died, and neither was Walter. And when I arrived in 2007, a few days after I arrived, the cross arrived, and they had been waiting 2.5 years for it. And it was a very potent moment to come with Walter and actually to put the cross on the grave, and it felt like a very big completion. And all the trees shook at the time that we did this little ritual for him, and I really felt he was with me, and he's always been with me in spirit. And that's another powerful message that the ayahuasca also has for us, is that it shows us that there's many dimensions on this planet, not just the three-dimensional one that we're so used to just living in, that there's many spirits and there's many things happening in all around us that we can't see. And the ayahuasca enables us to actually see the different dimensional levels that are existing on the planet. And once we recognize the different dimensional levels on the planet, we actually realize how interconnected everything is, that people don't really die, their bodies die, but their souls are with us all the time, and the essence of them is always with us, guiding us. During my apprenticeship, the shaman called me Linda Wawita, which means little baby, and at that time I was a child emotionally. And on the last day, we were sitting on the steps and the sun was setting, and we were both feeling the pain of me leaving. And he turned to me, Don Juanito, and he said, "You're no longer Linda Wawita, you're now an Amorosita." And at the time, my eyes welled with tears, because it was such a powerful thing for him to say, because an Amorosita is someone who's learning or has learned to love themselves. The power of ayahuasca is not to be a shaman. The power of ayahuasca is not to in any way feel that we are healing others, the power of ayahuasca is to heal ourselves. And only when we heal ourselves can we truly heal anything on the external world. And that's the power that, and the message and the wonderful, poignant process that I went through with Don Juanito. And I'm so grateful to him and to the ayahuasca for giving me the tools that I needed in order to heal myself.
Really powerful coming back now, because the mountains haven't changed. The village is completely different, but the mountains haven't changed. And it was the mountains that opened me up. It was this mountain that saved me from dying, and it was that mountain that woke me up to why I was living. And it was in the Amazon where I was really able to understand and reconnect fully and truly, using ayahuasca to connect with Mother Earth, to a point where I am able now to understand the rhythm and the natural flows of Mother Earth. And when we understand that we're not apart from nature, we're a part of nature, we're a part of this amazing planet, we actually understand the importance of life and the importance of living, and how wonderful and amazing and magical this world and this planet and Mother Earth really is. Kare ke kunawa, 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 kare ke k